Love should not be mistaken for weakness. There is no force more powerful than love. It's love that causes a firefighter to run into a burning building to save the lives of total strangers. It is love that drives a mother to run in front of a speeding car to save the life of her child. It is love that inspires a soldier to lay down their life to save the lives of others. It is love that inspires every one of us to care for each other, to fight for each other, to fight for our freedoms, to fight for our country. What our country needs now more than ever is the spirit of Aloha. That spirit of respect and love for one another and for our country. This is the most precious gift that Hawaii has to offer to our country and the world. Aloha. Because aloha is so much more than hello and goodbye. Aloha means I come to you with an open heart. I respect you. I have love for you and I care about you. Whether you are a friend or a stranger, I come to you with aloha. Regardless of the color of your skin, where you come from, how you worship God, who you love, or what political party you belong to. Dr. Martin Luther King saw this power of aloha when he first visited our islands and addressed our legislature. 1959. He said, "We look to you for inspiration and as a noble example, for you have already accomplished in the area of racial harmony and racial justice what we are struggling to accomplish in other sections of the country. And you can never know what it means to those of us caught for the moment in the tragic and often dark midnight of man's inhumanity to man, to come to a place where we see the glowing daybreak of freedom and dignity and racial justice." Now, after he returned back to the mainland, Dr. King said of his visit, "As I looked at all these various faces and various colors mingled together like the waters of the sea, I could see only one face, the face of the future. President John F. Kennedy, he also recognized this power of aloha when he visited Hawaii in 1963, and he said, we are proud of this city and this state and what it stands for. These islands represent all that we are and all that we hope to be. This is aloha." And this change we need to see must begin in the White House. Because the White House should be a beacon of aloha, respect, love, and compassion for every American. Our nation was founded on the values and principles of putting service before self. Rejecting the rule of kings who prospered from the sacrifices of the people, and forming a new nation founded on the premise that leaders should be motivated not to serve their own interests, but to serve the people. And deep inside the heart of every American is the love, honor, courage and ideals that form the foundation of this country. Ideals that still shine in each and every one of us. Each of us and all of us must rise again now and come together for each other, our country, and the world. Our cause to create a new and different path that reclaims our destiny and restores the uniquely American ideal. To seek a higher purpose, greater than ourselves, to put service before self. That is the cause that is calling to every American today. So I'm asking you to join me. I'm asking you to stand with me to build a movement of peace at home and abroad that will fulfill the promise of America, of freedom, justice, equality, and opportunity for all. First Sergeant called Specialist Cariaga, followed by silence. He called again, Specialist Dyson Cariaga, silence. And as he called for the last time, Specialist Dyson K. Cariaga, all of us were snapped when we heard the rifle salute, because Specialist Cariaga was no longer with us. We remember that along with the blessing that we have to have come home, we carry a heavy responsibility. Whether those of us who are veterans or those of us who are here as civilians, this responsibility that we share and carry is one to honor those who have paid that ultimate price and made that ultimate sacrifice. I will always place the mission first. I will never accept defeat. I will never quit. We will not neglect those who are injured, sick, or in need to fight for them, taking advantage of the time and the blessing of health and life that each of us has been granted. By making a positive impact on those around us, standing up and standing together and taking action. Some will say that we need to be patient. I think not.